Hello, and welcome to the Power of Authority podcast. I'm your host, Michelle Prince. Each week, you'll hear tips, stories, and inspiration from people who are leveraging the power of authority in their business, leadership, and life. It's time to get your story out of your head and onto paper so that you can grow your business, make a difference, and build your authority. After all, you can't spell authority without author. So let's get started. Hey, everybody, this is Michelle Prince. Welcome to the Power of Authority podcast. I am so excited to introduce you to our guest. We're going to have a quick interview, but it is going to be so powerful because it's my friend Kevin Harrington. Kevin Harrington is an original shark from the hit TV show Shark Tank and a successful entrepreneur for more than 40 years. He's the co-founding board member of the Entrepreneurs Organization and co-founder of the Electronic Retailing Association. He also invented the infomercial. He helped make, but wait, there's more, part of our cultural history. He's one of the pioneers behind the As Seen on TV brand, has heard more than 50,000 pitches and launched more than 50 products generating more than 5 billion, yes, that's billion with a B, in global sales. 20 of his companies have generated more than 100 million in revenue each. He's also the founder of the Secrets of Closing the Sale Masterclass, inspired by the master of sales, Zig Ziglar. He's the author of several best-selling books, including Act Now, How I Turn Ideas into Million-Dollar Products, Key Person of Influence, and Put a Shark in Your Tank. Hey, Kevin, welcome to the show.
Hey, that was a mouthful. Thank you, Michelle. Nice introduction. One clarification. You said I've done 50 products. It's 500. So
put a zero on that.
I was like, yeah, 50 products to do 5 billion. That'd be pretty good. But yeah, no, it's of the 500, we had over 100 that actually worked and paid us back a nice return on our investment, but about 400 that didn't work. So, you know, even as good as we think we are, we only succeed 1 out of 3, 1 out of 4, 1 out of 5 times,
yes,
which is pretty interesting.
Well, you and I had a chance to really get to know each other when we were filming the Secrets of Closing the Sale Masterclass, and which I absolutely loved. I loved the opportunity to interview you and do that with you. And I learned so much from you in terms of sales and branding and pitches. And talk a little bit about that. Like, where did your background in sales and how do you know all this stuff?
Well, good question. I'm one of 6 kids. But my dad, he was a bartender, not a wealthy guy. And you know, we grew up in modest upbringings. But he said, hey, he's going to save up enough money to open up his own bar, Harrington's Irish Pub. And then I started working in his places when I was 11. And he mentored me to be an entrepreneur. So he's like, Kevin, you have a job right now working for your dad who owns the business. You need own your own business. Okay.
Yes.
So, I started a driveway ceiling business in high school, a heating and air conditioning business in college, but I was literally knocking on doors, drive on my bicycle, pulling up to the house, knocking on the door, doing 10 driveways a week and during the summer when I was a kid. So I learned just kind of get out and do it. And by the way, the first 20 people that I knocked on their door, they didn't necessarily slam the door in my face, but there was not a welcome or a yes. So I had to learn how to deal with rejection very quickly. And once I figured it out, it was so amazing because I realized that people needed my service. I was a problem solver. They had cracks in their driveway that when the water got in them and froze, it was going to triple the size of the crack. So I'd bring them out and say, look, they'd say, look, I don't have any time. You're getting me in a bad time. Leave me alone. And I'd say, that's great. I understand. If you ever get a chance to check these cracks out, if you don't mind, let me show you one over here. And I'd pull his hand out the door. And now I'm walking him around the house. That crack's going to be triple the size next year because the water's going to freeze and triple it. And they're like, oh my God, wait, do you have a few more minutes? You could tell me more about this. And all of a sudden, boom, we're selling. So selling is an amazing thing. And having confidence is part of the process.
You know, one more thing I'm going to add to that I see in you is you have this work ethic and discipline. And I love that you point that out, that not all of your adventures or things that you pursue were successful, but you kept pursuing. And I think that's such a great message for entrepreneurs. You know, it may not just be the perfect easy road. And I have, so you've written so many books, you're speaking all over. I want to know a little bit more about what you're doing these days, but the show is called The Power of Authority. And how have you leveraged your authority, either in the book, on Shark Tank, on, you know, all of the courses that you've done? How are you seeing that by being an author that has really helped you to leverage it?
Yes. Yeah, so that's a great question, because a lot of people, I don't tell this story often, but I'm going to tell it right now, because I actually was an as seen on TV pioneer. I had, you know, I discovered Billy Mays and Tony Little and did all their first infomercials, Jack LaLanne and, you know, with George Foreman, et cetera. But I was building Billy Mays' brand, Tony Little's brand. Yes, I was making money, but when the dust settled, they had brands and I didn't. Mm. I had some capital from the success of the ventures. And so I got some good advice. Richard Branson, I hung with him at Necker Island. And he's like, Kevin, why haven't you built your own brand? So I said, great idea, good question, and maybe something I should do. So I came home with a game plan to start writing books, creating content to build my brand. And so my first book was called Act Now, How I Turn Ideas into $1 Million Products. And as I was promoting that out in the marketplace, doing radio talk shows, TV talk shows, trade show keynotes at the Houseware Show, the Hardware Show, I started building my brand. But little did I know who was looking for a shark that came out of the product business. Mark Burnett. And that the book came out right when Mark was looking on the internet for someone, and I was all over the place. So I say that my desire to go build my authority was writing the book and creating content. And that's what got me on Shark Tank. So you never know what's going to happen. You never know what doors get open when you start creating amazing content, putting out good books that give good information to people. And now I've got 6 or 7 books out, many of them bestsellers. And we're shooting video content almost on a daily basis now. So you have to raise your profile and gain that power of authority. It's a must.
Well, and that's why I asked you to not only just write a testimonial for my book, The Power of Authority, but I put you on the front cover because I think you are just one of the most perfect examples of that. You know, it's not necessarily about the book, but it's about the brand and you know, what you're putting out there. And it does give you this instant credibility, this instant authority. And, you know, I love the story that you got on Shark Tank because of your book. So I thank you so much. You know, I know you have a passion for entrepreneurs. So if you could give one piece of advice to new entrepreneurs or people starting in their business today, in the trenches, what would you say?
One of the big things that I feel that I lacked in some of my entrepreneurial developments, because I was kind of a headstrong guy. Yep, my dad said, go start a business, but he wasn't there helping me run the business. I ran into many obstacles as I was building my business. And so I was trying to get the right people, but I didn't even know how to get the right people. Running an ad in the newspaper, classifieds, right? Well, that isn't necessarily the best way. Those are people that are typically unemployed. You need to get a dream team to surround yourself to support your skill set. Now, I was a marketing sales guy. I didn't have skills in operations and finance or raising capital. I brought on a former bank president to support my team as in the finance and ops side. And this guy did amazing things, got us lines of credit, capital. And then we went from $50 million a year to over $500 million a year because we ended up getting capital. And so this, I think, is one of the key things. If you're an entrepreneur, you're starting out, you can't do it all yourself. I'm not saying go hire all these people and pay them big salaries. Get creative, get mentors, get advisors, bring on a board of advisors, get a dream team, and then you're going to have a much better chance of growing your business.
Love that. Awesome advice. What are you most excited about coming up this next year?
Well, I have three kind of legs in my stool. One is the first leg is products. And we do over $100 million a year with our products currently. And that's one leg. The second leg is speaking engagements. Last year, 85. Next year, we'll see. It's probably going to be similar numbers, if not more. And then the third is the investments that I've made and oversee. I've got equity in 25 companies. So we help every one of those. I'm part of their dream team on each one. So every day is a new day. I never know what's going to hit me till I see my emails in the morning sometimes. But that's what makes life exciting, interesting. I travel a lot. So overseeing the investments, advising companies, making more investments and running products and speaking, all of the above is cool. And there's always two or three that I'm focused on that have great possibilities. And that's the fun part, is seeing some of these things take. I mean, just real quick, I had one that went from 10 cents a share as a small public company to over $4. And, when you get a 40x return on your investment, that's what it's all about. That's what investing is all about. You look for those home runs.
That is awesome. How can people get a hold of you, Kevin?
Real simple. Just go to my website, kevinharrington.tv. And there's all kinds of, kind of little free giveaways there and downloads you can get. But also, if you want to pitch me or leave me some information, there's a place there you can do that. And I'd love to work with any of the folks that you send my way. So have a mention that we heard them through Michelle Prince's Power of Authority podcast.
Awesome. Kevin, thank you so much. I adore you. And I'm just so grateful to have you on the show.
Hey, thanks, Michelle. Appreciate it. And I'll see you soon. I know you've got some good events coming up.
Yes.
All over the place. But God bless and have a great one. Thank you.
Thanks. All right. So if you're ready to start leveraging the power of authority in your business and life, then go ahead and go to thepowerofauthority.com. You're going to get a free copy of my brand new book. Just pay shipping. We'll send it out to you. And it's time. Get your story out there and start leveraging it. See you next time. Thanks for listening to this episode of the Power of Authority podcast. Be sure to subscribe so you don't miss an episode and find me on social media and let me know what did you like best about this episode. And don't forget, share this with a friend. We'll see you soon.